I love sleeping. Thing is, I barely do it, and my health is probably deteriorating because of it. Human beings spend, on average, a third of our lives asleep, but our nightly routines could be hindering the amount of sleep we're actually getting. Tech is pretty awful for our sleep schedules. Screens, blue light, phone usage, they're all huge factors that can threaten a good night's sleep. So, what can we do to make sure we're getting the best sleep? How can tech actually benefit our bedtimes? How does tech affect our sleep? Before the modern age, it was actually pretty common for people to wake up in the middle of the night and do simple tasks before returning back to bed. There wasn't just sleep. There was a first sleep and a second sleep. And people did things like smoke, pray, or like present-day humans, go pee. With industry came noise, as the Industrial Revolution made people long for the days when sleep was as easy as just closing your eyes at the end of the day. Technology is sleep's greatest enemy, and just as the clanging of iron factories in the past kept people from snoozing, today's tech is keeping people from getting a good night's sleep. To understand why, we have to understand sleep. If you've been having trouble sleeping lately, you're not alone. A recent survey by the Smithsonian revealed that almost one-third of Americans sleep less than 6 hours a night. And that includes me. I just can't help myself. There's too many things on television, and I just can't keep up. Everybody says that the recommended amount of healthy sleep is 8 hours a night. This is part of your circadian rhythm. Your circadian rhythm keeps you on schedule. It's why you wake up in the morning and go to bed in the evening, and how your body allocates energy between both, making it pretty important to maintain. A biological clock, if you will. In the brain, your hypothalamus helps control this rhythm. See, your brain creates a hormone called melatonin, which makes you feel drowsy. Typically, this hormone is produced during the evening and nighttime, thanks to the absence of sunlight. Unless you live in some parts of Alaska, in which case you get sunlight 24 hours a day for months. But when you are exposed to light, your hypothalamus signals your pineal gland to stop producing melatonin, meaning you feel less drowsy, making it harder to go to sleep. The less melatonin in the brain, the rockier your sleep-wake cycle. It's just a no-go. And this is where our pocket iron factories, or phones, come in. When we use our phones before bed, we expose our eyes to light, reducing melatonin production in our brain. And it's not just any light, it's blue light. These blue light waves, on top of already helping to suppress melatonin production, can also cause what's called digital eye strain. When you use screens, you blink much less than normal. An average person blinks about 15 times a minute, but that can drop all the way down to only 5 times a minute when using a device. This leads to dried and strained eyes, blurry vision, and even headaches. And it's not just your phone. Your television, tablet, desktop, laptop, pretty much everything you own with a screen can cause these effects. A screen like this one! Using devices before bed can be super detrimental to your eye health, your sleep schedule, and circadian rhythm. Just a few hours before bed can cause grogginess in the morning, all thanks to less melatonin in your blood. If you're not a morning person, like me, maybe consider cutting down screen time and reading a book or something. Or listening to a podcast. There's another auditory avenue you can take to lull yourself to sleep. You can listen to white noise to tune out the rest of the world. White noise is consistent noise that doesn't deviate from a central frequency. This helps the listener fall asleep because they're focused on a constant noise rather than noises changing in pitch and frequency. This is why some people feel like listening to the ocean is good for sleep. Or in my case, Bob Ross.
And a little tree over here.
Now I know I made the case for tech being sleep's biggest enemy, but some tech does want to help us sleep. There are a plethora of sleep apps and websites dedicated to helping people around the world reach Snoozeville. These apps claim to track your sleep by measuring things like snoring, body movement, sleep talking, and other habits. Then they use this information to help you foster better sleeping practices. In the morning, users awake to find detailed reports of times they moved, when they entered specific sleep cycles, when REM sleep occurred, if they snored, and when they awoke. And lots of people find them helpful. Though doctors think this can be attributed to a placebo effect, where because you're using something meant to help you sleep, you believe that it does. The problem is that the information being given to these users isn't necessarily accurate. Pets hopping on and off your bed, partners waking up to pee in the middle of the night, your phone falling off the edge, they're all commonplace events that can happen on any given night of sleep, resulting in inaccurate readings of your sleep activity. Essentially, none of these apps can account for human idiosyncrasies. So if you're gonna use the apps, use them with a grain of salt, or just kick screen usage altogether. Experts say that the best sleep can be achieved in a dark room with no distractions. But I don't trust being alone in the dark with my thoughts for more than 2 minutes. The sleep market is expected to reach $76 billion this year as more people become aware of how important a healthy sleep really is. In 2018, we saw wearables and gadgets being developed to help toss-and-turners achieve rest at tech and trade shows like CES. Gadgets like the Nokia Sleep, yes, that Nokia, which is a sleep sensor housed inside a fabric pad that users keep under their mattresses. The sensor connects to your Wi-Fi and tracks sleep, much like sleep apps do. Philips also introduced their Smart Sleep, a headband that monitors sleep. They claim that its bone conduction headphones broadcast a custom audio tone to keep your deep sleep even deeper. Then there's this whole next level Internet of Things concept for getting sleep using your entire bedroom. Chinese company SleepPace pitched DreamLife, a three-part system that uses a sensor, cloud storage, and your smart devices to not just monitor your sleep, but prepare your entire bedroom whenever you lay down to rest. Imagine laying down in your bed and your entire room just shuts off. Sign me up. Today, you can buy blue light filter glasses from a bunch of different retailers like Warby Parker or Gunner, so you can be stylish and keep that melatonin count high. Old habits die hard. And that includes using your phone before bed. If you're not a morning person, if you never get sleep, if you can't remember the last time you woke up feeling rested, it's time to make some changes. Consider cutting screen time before bed. Maybe use a sleep app despite their flaws. Look, I did some research for this script and I actually stopped sleeping with a light on. And I have to admit, it has helped me fall asleep. I'm afraid of the dark, so it's kind of a big deal. Either way, if you're stubborn and you want to stick to your guns, I get that, and tech might catch up with you. It might help you get a good night's sleep with minimal effort. It might not be tomorrow, and it might not be that easy, but hey, we can dream, right? Hey guys, thank you so much for watching ContECHtual. If you liked this episode, please make sure to leave a comment below and tell us what you liked about it. And if you have ideas for new episodes for next season, let us know in the comments as well. We have new episodes coming out every Thursday, so if you want to keep track of all the new episodes coming out, please like and subscribe to our page. And as always, have a great day.